my game a little bit.
I wrote it. I don't need to look at it. Right. So I made some revisions based on. So what I realized, right, and which I knew, was that most of this I filled out based on discussions we had. But the section that we talked about last time, the process, some of that is what we had done. Some of it was stuff I invented. And so that was sort of the discussion last time of, well, what about this? What about this? And so I edited it to sort of reflect the discussion we had and sort of the things that we might do or have done. So that's the only thing that's changed between this version and the one that we looked at last week, other than a couple small edits that are inconsequential. So I don't know. I guess this is actually a question that goes beyond the FAQ. Is this process that is described here how we want to do things, right? I mean, I think that's actually, it's not a question about the FAQ, it's, is this an accurate representation of how we would like to handle things?
Just that we'll know it when we see it. It says we'll know it when it sees it, but also I'm not feeling that.
So that came
about that.
Right.
It's like clarity.
Yes. So though I will say those three I did not write. Those came from the guide. Those are copy and pasted from the guidelines that we discussed back in February, I think it was.
Yeah.
But we can talk.
I've just taken it out. I had a similar sense of just vague unease that it's a bit, you know, I mean,
it's
understand the
flip.
Sentiment, but it,
yeah,
it's probably just to be.
And given that some people are nervous about this committee.
Trust us. We'll know it. This point of this is to sort of say, okay, we're trying to be transparent.
Okay.
I would suggest striking it.
And do we have agreement then to strike it from the guidelines document too, that has not been posted yet, but that we previously adopted?
I would think that would be appropriate, yes.
That's fine. I was just trying to find it in my document. Deleted. So are people comfortable with the process that
I
articulated?
Yeah, I'm sorry.
No, that's okay. I just want to, because it's not the process, it's not exactly what we've been doing, but we also have never actually discussed our process of, right.
Well, where do you think it's something that we haven't been doing?
Well, so if you think about what we just did with ECAC and with the Finance Committee charge, we did make revisions to it, and then we just sent it to the council. I don't know that we sent it back to, well, I mean, as I was the person for ECAC,
right?
So, but it never went back to finance to say, here are our revisions, are you okay with that? Which is why I think we had a question from the vice chair of finance saying, well, hold on, you changed this, why? And we were able to explain it, but the way process, you know, here. Now, of course, it might be, we might have a little bit more flexibility when it's a council committee charge, right? We wouldn't want to just take a measure that was written by a citizen and send it to the council without
right.
being like, hey, we changed these
mm-hmm.
things. But technically, we didn't follow this with finance and the ECAC revisions that we just made. So.
But it seems like a good idea.
Mm-hmm.
I know we haven't been following it, which is where I sort of last time was like,
right.
well, what's going on? So I like the provision that was added about the sort of conditional, the contingent declaration, so that we don't have to say, okay, we're ready to go,
mm-hmm.
go look at it, and 3 weeks later it comes back to
right.
us for the final vote.
Right.
So I was happy to see that we can
yeah.
sort of use that so that then,
right.
As chair, we could just send it back to them with a, we've declared it with these changes.
Right.
If you accept that, it's ready to go to the council.
And then the other thing that I added that was different from the first one was the last bullet, because I realized how I had written in the first bullet was that we will work with them to make it consistent, but there could theoretically be something that comes to us that's like, we cannot make, like, this will never work, right?
Right.
We will never say that,
mm-hmm.
like, if someone came back and they said, we are going to, you know, do something that clearly violates some state law, we can't be like, well, okay, we'll help you make this, you know, so that we can declare it. I think the old one was that inevitably we will always declare something clear, consistent, actionable if they accept our revisions, but there might be some things we find that are unrevisable.
Right.
So I added that we might just
right.
look at something and say, you know what, we're not even going to work on this because it's so clearly not
mm-hmm.
actionable.
Is that different than the SharePoint?
Yes.
Yeah.
The website, the town website, so that other
okay.
people have access to it.
Right.
Right now, they're not there yet.
Okay.
So I'll make that. I was waiting for this one to go before I made the formal request to say.
Council committees. Is there anything on it?
What?
I was wondering if there was any documents on our website, but there isn't.
Well, there's packets available in minutes and all, but not
oh,
the ones we've passed.
Right.
You know, so I'll
agendas,
also
minutes, packets.
other thing. So the next thing on our agenda was a continued discussion of a TMAC proposal. I reached out to Meg for our conversation last week. I reached out to her Monday, and I received the email back that I'm going to read her response, which is, my apologies, forgot getting back to you sooner. She forgot to get back to me sooner, but I had emailed her Monday. We would like to pause before submitting another version of our proposal until it's clearer to us and everyone how this idea could be most useful and how it might be best structured. So with appreciation for your invitation for us to submit another version that more accurately relates to the council's structure and goals, we will submit something in a couple of months, hopefully before the summer. I'll keep you appraised of our timing and thinking. And she asked whether it would work for me, and I told her that would be fine. So that means if we had last week, or the last meeting, I think, talked about two potential avenues. One was, what do they want? Do they want us to do a charge? Clearly, they're saying on that grounds, pause.
Yeah.
So my recommendation is to pause that one until they get back to us. But the other one was, do we want to come forward with some sort of potential council internal policy that incorporates their sort of, what did they call it, the SURF, or the sort of thinking, that sort of document, and for reporting purposes. And so I'd like the committee's thoughts on, should we pause this whole thing, or should we continue to go go forward with that sort of potential possibility or not.
So I've been trying to, the problem I've had with this entire thing and with it coming to GeoWill is I'm just not sure if people have ideas of what that would look like. So we could say every council committee, whenever you put forth a policy, you have to issue a report that looks like the one that they did, right? I mean, we could say that. I don't know that I would want to do that, because I'm thinking, would we have wanted to do that for public ways, which we would have had to do, right? And maybe that would have made sense, but then it also, it would have been an additional thing we would have had to do before bringing that to the council. But outside of saying every committee has to submit this type of report, I'm just not sure what such a recommendation would look like. So do people have ideas, or should we just?
I think it's a useful lens, you know, mm-hmm. that impact study that they have suggested. Because we do forget things. Mm-hmm. We're human of us. And, oh, we forgot to look at the impact of this on blank. I'm not sure what to do with it. I mean, I think we could say that this is a recommended checklist
right. For
any major policy or any major measure. It would be nice if we could come up with something that sort of mitigates, you know, in other words, we have a 2-month pause here, but it'd be nice to come up with something that gave them confidence that we're, you know, acting in a way that they, you know, that they're interested. I don't know, not
right. That
we're not, but, you know, adopt some or all.
I would be concerned about adding, somewhat echoing Evan, adding another layer of what you want to call it, process, bureaucratic review, that could become quite cumbersome and time-consuming, and probably in many cases not even appropriate, but perhaps in those cases you could quickly check off everything and be done with it. But. And I'm also uncomfortable with us, again, sort of saying this is what we want committees to do.
No, I just went looking.
We've also kicked it to CRC, right? And,
right. No, it's not with them yet.
Well,
it's
get
just
to them. Well, again, wait a minute. I thought, in other words, we suggested that was an option.
Right.
But they have reached out to you, and they're going to pause, so they're not going to CRC either. Okay, so it's with us.
I think that we're talking about it as a positive checklist around impact, and that's directly related to CRC. So it seems to me that a way to be effective and supportive of the people who brought it is to look at that impact and see how today, and see how we can incorporate it and make it part of the process that we're using, because that's our goal, is to look at impact across all areas. So I feel less driven right now to deal with it in here.
One of the benefits of the impact is that we would require people to bring forward a measure to a tax map. And so if you want to have a ordinance, don't fly kites on the common on Sundays, you would look through the checklist, and maybe you would, your desire to bring this forward would be diminished, or maybe it would be amplified.
Sure what we could do with it in terms of, I think, what George and Evan were mentioning policy-wise. What would it look like coming out of here instead of just a, hey, CRC, we as a council want to see this. You know, how does that look coming out of GOL in terms of a recommendation? And
right.
I think that's what we need to figure out. Does it come out of GOL as a recommendation for all policies, just bylaw changes that would be enforceable? You know, I mean, are we looking at resolutions? What's the impact of a resolution similar to the 100% renewable resolution? Would something like that require it? Or because that's not really an enforceable thing, is it only things
right.
that would be enforceable? Not everything that comes to the council that would have a bylaw type enforceability is going to get referred to CRC. And that's why I think I was in favor of it coming to this council for some, this committee for some sort of discussion versus CRC, because not everything's going to go to them. But what do we do with it?
Yeah.
I think we could start working on crafting some sort of recommended internal policy that maybe is not so formal, you know, that we recommend that the council request any report recommending the adoption of, say, a bylaw, report back on the impacts to, housing, property owner, and just come up with just a big broad
mm-hmm.
list, positive and negative impacts. You know, could we as a committee craft something like that? And how would that look? And what would that look like to the full council? So it's not just CRC that would be burdened by it. I still think it would be useful to have something like that reported in writing before the full council. Having taken place in a subcommittee somewhere for all those impacts. Or a subset of those impacts. Maybe we have to give each committee the leeway to not do it for every single category so it doesn't become tremendously burdensome. I don't know. But the question is, do
yeah,
we as
yeah,
a committee want to try
saying.
And craft something?
So we're seeing this as falling under the broad category of good governance and seeing it as our responsibility, or could be our responsibility, given this committee's charge, to come up with some sort of set of suggestions or rubric or guideline to further good governance. Is that basically what I'm hearing here? It's we're trying to assist the council in being in this process of good governance and the creating some mandating or requiring or requesting some sort of impact statement for a certain category or categories of actions we would consider to be, and we would define that, you know, describe the impact statement or whatever, but that would be considered a good governance thing to do. Is that why we're doing this? Is because it's ultimately around the idea of good governance? And we're trying to create some kind of rubric or policy that would further that? Is that what people want? That sounds good to me, but I'm just wondering, is that where you see it coming from, or is this more because someone has brought something forward, we feel obligated to somehow do something
see,
about
I
it?
I really think everything that you said applies to CRC, because, and it seemed to me that by law and resolution would be coming to but it also a bylaw change might be coming to CRC, particularly when you talk about housing and all of those things. So I feel like it's an extra layer that doesn't necessarily have to be taken on by this committee.
But Manny's argument is that this sort of issue can come up in other places besides CRC, and it might be useful for us to start the process and start the dialogue and start crafting something. And
let me give you an example of something that might come up that might not, that would be bylaw. I'll give two examples that would be bylaw changes that might not fit appropriately into a CRC review or even a financial review. The first one is what the Ranked Choice Voting Commission will bring forth to us, which would be a bylaw in terms of adopting the process for how to rank choice vote in town. That probably doesn't fall under CRC's charge at all. That goes to sort of our continued discussion of recommendations related to the GOL charge in some sense. That's going to be a bylaw. It's going to come to us not necessarily for a policy review, but for something else. There should be a policy review. It should probably have an impact statement of some sort. You know, we should, whenever that comes to the council, be looking at what are the benefits of this bylaw, but what are the drawbacks? Mm-hmm. Are there drawbacks? There are, you know, some financial drawbacks, but are there any drawbacks in terms of voting participation and all? And having a rubric to report out on that might be useful from a good governance point of view. The other example I had was one I was thinking of eventually proposing is contribution limits on election in running for town local elections. Again, not a CRC thing, would be a bylaw. Would it be good to have some sort of impact-ish statement relating to various things? You know, various, you don't necessarily fall under housing, but you do probably fall under a social justice mantle on something like limiting how much any one person can donate to any one local campaign, potentially.
And that's in terms of social justice, that's even debatable.
Right.
Those two examples I feel comfortable with in terms of impact.
I think their impact, I mean, I think what they were proposing and the concerns that they brought up were almost 100% CRC type things, land use type things. And in fact, one of their checklist things is maintaining the small town feel. I can't pull it up because I don't on my phone, but they have something like maintain the small town feel of Amherst. So finger on the scale, but the I think that's really where their concern is, this CRC type stuff. So that's why I think that CRC, a request that CRC look at some sort of an impact statement influenced by what they've started, I think might be a good idea. I actually do think it is a good idea because right now we'd expect the finance committee to weigh in, we'd expect the town manager's office to weigh in. So I do think it's useful to have, we forgot to ask if there's, I mean, let's take the bridge example was not a, it was a measure, but it was reallocating funds. But that would have been an interesting one to have run through that checklist because we all had our own checklist. So it would have been nice to have sort of a universal checklist that we, and but then there's nothing to say that you have to meet all of them or any of them. You know, we could still vote aye if it doesn't meet any of them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we could.
Are you imagining that it would be required by some entity to produce?
I think the applicant, whoever the proponent is. Oh. So, like in the case of the bridge, it would have been the DPW or the really town manager's office.
So I guess the argument that is also being made by proposers and also by John Horner, spoke in favor of this, was that proposers are always going to paint the rosy picture of this, right?
Right.
There are no environmental impacts to this coal plant, right?
No, it's
and so you sort of need...
Well, they're minimal. And
right. And so I think that's why, to me, this does make complete sense to be within CRC, right? And it almost seems like CRC should be adopting some... CRC's, one of your jobs is to, well, I'm saying because you're on it, jobs is to evaluate and review proposed policies that impact these things, right? And at some point, just as we had to decide, what do we mean by clarity, consistency, action, you all are going to have to decide, how are we evaluating things? And that's where this discussion comes in. I understand your point of there are some things that will go to CRC, right? But I'm looking at this and I'm thinking for ranked choice voting, right? Mm-hmm. So maybe social impacts, but probably not environmental impacts, maybe economic. It seems so mitigate, compatibility, unintended. I also don't know what E and F mean in this, but that's besides the point. To some extent, I don't know how don't know. I think that.
You don't think that us, that this group, I mean, obviously I'm not looking for work for us to do, but you don't think it would be fruitful for us to just look at this and sort of see what, I mean, for instance, ENF, maybe if we created something like this, that would go out or would be changed. I mean, you don't think it would be fruitful for us to have this discussion. It should be, CRC should take care of it.
I think
I mean, they got
there
a lot of,
are very few things that would, such an analysis like this would be appropriate for that would not come out of CRC. And I almost feel like those things, rank choice voting, whatever, could be dealt with on an ad hoc basis. As much as we've been trying to move away from ad hoc, I don't know that we need a formal framework above CRC. I do share, you know, some of these, because I expressed to Mandy when we were leaving council Monday night that I actually was really uncomfortable with the fact that we passed a $32 million budget without a single comment from a councilor, right? Like, committed the town to, we had a public hearing before that was very quick because we were all trying to get out of it as fast as possible to get to the smart growth. But that was like, to me, if I was the public watching that, I'd go, they just committed the town to $16 million and no one even had anything to say about it, right? And so I think to the good governance part is actually showing the community we have thought these things through and we're not. I think the Monday night's meeting to something, and I heard people say this, was a good example of rushing through an agenda, which is everyone wants to get out early, but the feeling of you're making some big decisions and there doesn't seem to be a lot of debate on them, right? And so I think having something like this paired with that can say, look, no, we've actually considered these things beforehand, even if you're not seeing, even if the show isn't there at prime time, right? But I just don't necessarily know what this looks like outside of the context of CRC.
Say we decided to change the speed limit in town.
That's good, right?
Yeah.
Do we want to go through something like this? Would it be appropriate? It certainly wouldn't be CRC's business, but
it's
public ways.
Yep,
it's
CRC.
It would fall under CRC.
Say we want to change some bylaw related to alcohol regulations or marijuana dispensaries or whatever. Is that CRC too?
You can put a CRC lens on almost everything.
That's terrifying.
Which is a little tricky. Right. It puts everything on that committee, and that committee's going to have
good.
A ton of work done, which is why we're
going
to seg into that other discussion we've been continuing for
right.
a while.
Another aspect of CRC is that we can have residents support us and do work
mm-hmm.
with in subcommittees and stuff with counselors to study impact, and that would address John Hornick's thing about you need, and Hilda's about needing oppositional things, not just the rosy picture. And I think that feels critical to me in a certain kind of way. So that we're looking at all this work for CRC, but I think it's a way, one of the main things I felt like the people really were saying is we want to have some input.
Yep, yep.
I mean, most of the proposers are, like myself, are former town meeting members. And I think that finding ways to integrate opinions into CRC, because we are only five people, we will not be able to do everything that we potentially could do. But sort of off, that's the CRC discussion. I could see having a checklist for certain kinds of issues, like, you know, mandatory voting or something like that, but making it very clear what the governance aspect of the way we're working is.
So one thing is, I really think we should be strengthening our committees. You know, I think we need to weed and strengthen. Sometimes you have to cut down a committee or for other ones to grow stronger, but I think we need to be strengthening the committee. So I think that, and that was one of the reasons that I inherently was not in favor of this, because I think there are other committees. So like the CRC might say for the speed limit or whatever, we don't have the information that we need, so we're going to refer this to these two other, you know, transportation advisory or what, you know, whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
And then we might say, but there isn't a committee that deals with, like, we don't have an economic development committee of the town yet. So maybe that's what one of the things that comes out of this is. The economic development question is a really big question for anything that, you know, any measure that we, including speed limit, frankly.
Right.
you know, any measure that we adopt. So maybe that would be a way of addressing this, is an economic development committee that looks at, that we see it, we can take some of the issues that they're identifying.
Can I just clarify?
Yep.
Are you an economic development committee
of the town?
Council? Okay.
Of the town.
Of the town.
Just checking.
Yeah.
I hadn't thought of it, but Steve makes a good point. You know, one of the things the proponents of this were saying was when, say, Transportation Advisory comes in with a proposal, they're only looking at that. But that doesn't prohibit CRC from receiving that proposal or the council receiving that proposal and say, hey, well, this also is going to impact economic development or this. We're going to send it to those committees for their recommendation.
And that's one thing that never happened with town meeting.
Yeah, which never happened, but we don't have to just receive a recommendation from the originating sponsor committee. We can go to, you know, Public Works or the refuse, it's not existence anymore, but we can go to the ECAC committee, we can go to the zoning subcommittee, or planning board, or we can ask for what's your opinion on this?
Right.
And I think
use that expertise to do essentially what this impact statement.
Right. And that facilitates a broader kind of communication and hopefully deepens everyone's understanding.
I almost like that more than an impact statement coming directly from CRC in a sense. Like, utilize these town committees.
Yeah, utilize them, but
again, we'd still have
to.
Yeah, you'd still have to do it.
So that,
and
what if we don't agree with the event, you know?
Right, but you would then be synthesizing the four different committees' review of that single policy.
Right.
And then adding your own.
Right.
Or not.
So what I'm hearing now is that having a piece of paper or a document that is really not what people are looking for, but just a kind of general sense that the expertise is out there, we just need to call on it.
Yeah.
Which is my feeling from day one. But,
I want to hear
some pushback here because
because to me there is this intense reliance on experts without looking and without opening it and saying that if you're a renter, you have a real different experience than someone who's not a renter, a homeowner. And my experience now in my life is very different than yours when you're still renting. So we need both on committees. And what I'm seeing in a lot of the ways we're making up committees is that it is a social justice aspect, and it cuts across all kinds of lines or sex or whatever. And I think that we need that, and we're not, you know, this reliance on experts of only one stripe is I think, very limiting. I really do think it's limiting. So
to go forward with George's trying to move us forward and summarize, it sounds like we as a committee here are not really in favor of proposing some sort of internal rule or policy for how other committees, or recommending some sort of policy for how committees of the council committees should be looking at the issues brought to them. At the same time, it sounds like we've come up with some potential uses that committees could make of other committees and other things, and that this one document is only one of many things, like referring out to other non-sponsoring committees and stuff, so that I could include that in a report of, you know, here's some other ideas on how to get that broader range of perspectives, but that each committee should probably come up with their own policies on how they want to do that reporting instead of the council recommending a universal policy.
Or this committee.
Well, this committee, it would go back to the council for vote, which is why I say the council, committee recommending to the council some universal policy that the council may then adopt. Is that what I'm hearing?
Yes. I need to see it written down.
Yeah.
Which good luck writing.
Yeah, I'm doing my best, Chair, but I don't think it's going to look much like it.
I mean, I feel very, I really like our committee. I think it's an important committee. But I'm so aware of the tension in other people in the community and on the council that the idea of requiring and, you know, all of that stuff, we need to let go of for a while. We need to work more gently this year, I think.
So I like the idea of sort of shopping things out to other committees, and then at some point, someone has to synthesize that information.
Yep.
I imagine 98% of the time it will be CRC because they will fall into that. I think GOL can be a much like,
100%.
Right, it can be just the, I was going to say trash bin, but that doesn't but you know what I mean? Where it doesn't fit in this recycling or this compost or this, so we'll just throw it in there,
right?
And so I think to some extent we can serve as the backup if it doesn't seem like it fits in CRC and it doesn't fit in something else. Because that's sort of how we've been used already. It's like, like the reason we're even talking about this TMAC proposal, it was sort of a, it doesn't seem to fit. We don't want to give it to CRC just yet, and it doesn't make sense anywhere else. So, but generally speaking, I do like that. I also think I would just like to wait a little bit and see what CRC comes up with for how they're going to evaluate things, and then maybe return to this discussion.
You know,
in the future.
Because we also might be getting a revised proposal from the proposers
in a couple of months.
Yeah, in a couple months, and so.
So the CRC, the CRC needs something to evaluate in order to. In other words, we can come up with sort of a theoretical checklist. I mean, this has to do with all of our committees, basically.
Right.
We can come up with a theory of what's a good practice, but we need a practice to prove the theory or to adjust the theory.
Right.
What I'm hearing is essentially, I will report out on today's sort of discussion consensus of we are postponing, I don't want to say indefinitely, but kind of indefinitely, by consensus, not a vote, the TMAC referral, the referral that the council made to us to discuss the content of this proposal until two things. One, the proposers, the sponsors of the original proposal decide whether they want to move forward with proposing an actual committee charge. And two, until CRC kind of gets their legs under them. And then maybe we'll take it back up after that. In the meantime, I will report out our discussion about this universal policy. We're not really for having the council adopt some sort of universal policy, and we're not prepared to make any recommendation to that sense, and I'll try and write something up about that. That brings us to discussion item number 4, which is continued discussion of recommendations related to the GOL committee charge. And this one, we almost sort of ventured into it a little bit, right? Is that not closing? But we've got our charge. And that charge, I'm going to try and bring it up, but says essentially gives us two things. And now we have a CRC committee, but we're trying to figure out for things that don't follow CRC. Mm-hmm. As Evan just so eloquently said, should we be the trash bin of the...
You don't have to put that in the minutes.
It's on video, though.
Oh.
All right,
but
it's not in the minutes, so it's not a
thing. Yeah, so we've had multiple discussions on this in terms of modifying this charge and all, and we're kind of stuck so far, and maybe we can move forward on a couple of things related to this charge. But where we were the last time we discussed this, it was kind of my understanding was we feel there needs to be a committee that needs to review the policy implications of proposed bylaws, mainly bylaws, but potential resolutions to. But we were hesitant to recommend a new committee to do that, yet we were also hesitant to say GOL should be the one that gets all the leftover stuff that doesn't fall to CRC.
Right.
And they are diametrically opposed opinions, in a sense.
Yeah.
So I think we need to come to some sort of conclusion so that we can update our own charge,
right,
and get other changes that we want to make to our charge made, number one. But so that we can put this conversation to rest and make a recommendation however way we decide, and maybe then the council can rehab this conversation. I'm going to take my privilege and say one other thing. When rules eventually will, all the council rules will be coming to us eventually to be the monitor of. There are some questions about that will be coming to the whole town council, because rules is divided on whether to adopt to recommend one thing or another, and one of those questions relates to council committees and whether committees themselves should be able to adopt some things without a council vote, or not, and that we've got two separate rules. I see this potential charge as, and one of the things one of the committee members there was mentioning was, you know, some arguments were, no, the charges should be specific enough to give that authority or not, instead of an overarching universal rule. And so there was an acknowledgement by one committee member that when we were passing some of these charges, we didn't quite know what we wanted out of the committees and what kind of authority we wanted to give them. And so I'd like us to be able to go back to the council and say, here's the authority we think GOL should have based on stuff, but here's an authority that's missing and maybe GOL shouldn't, but maybe we should be adding it to another committee charge or what.
Yeah.
I'd like to be able to get it into a charge somehow, because we've struggled with, do we have that authority or not? So that's my preface. Take it away on continuing this diametrically opposed opinions on what we should do.
Can I bring up things that are not that first?
Go for it.
So, I think we've already agreed, so I'm just looking at the chart right now, I think we've already agreed that we're definitely going to ask to revise the second bullet. This is review bylaws and resolutions, to just say review measures. Is that correct? Because we also currently technically don't have authority to review committee charges. I feel like we've already decided that, but I mean, we haven't had this discussion in a while. Is that correct?
I think so, yes.
Yeah.
I'm trying to find my last edit to this charge.
Because we've been looking at committee charges, but which technically has never been in our charge.
Right.
And that was the argument that ECAC, as a company included, made about why we shouldn't look at the CAC.
Cool.
I think we should have.
Oh.
But at the time, I was like, well, technically, it shouldn't go there, because it doesn't say committee charges. It says bylaws and resolutions. The other part is that first bullet, advise the town council on matters of internal rules, governance, and organization. There has been a lot of debate in the council about what that means.
Yep.
So when we have said we want to do these things with town committees, there has been, especially from one councilor, who has felt like in the internal, so you could read this as internal rules is one, governance is another, and organization is another. Or you could read this as internal rules, internal governance, internal organization, right? To what does the internal apply? And there seems to be disagreement with that, so that when we said we want to request committees review their charges, some people said, you're only dealing with the town council. This is internal rules and internal governance. And we've been sort of interpreting governance to mean governance.
Right.
So I think we also have to, I think that the bigger conversation is the one that Amanda Joe brought up, but I actually think that in the recent past, that first bullet has actually caused us more headaches when we bring things to the council itself, is how are we interpreting that? And maybe it's worthwhile to clarify, are we only focused on what the council does, or are we also focused on the governance of the town?
What I get really worried about is that we'll have these highly restrictive committee charges.
Mm-hmm.
So we don't have the headspace to do sort of necessary work on the council, because it's too big, agendas are too packed. So we've developed this committee structure. And if we have too much shoe pounding over every time a committee comes up with a good idea, then we're going to be completely paralyzed. Mm-hmm. So I think that in some ways we need to get the boat out past the waves. And so what we saw is that looking at all the committee structures, caused some anxiety. So maybe, you know, this isn't the right time. I firmly believe this is the right committee, because what other committee would do it?
Right.
And I think that every action that the committee takes, one of the committees should be able to handle that. I mean, it should be in the purview of one of those committees. We should stop forming ad hoc committees of the council. So, and it may be that we simply have to add to the list at this point, but now we know, it's like the game. My favorite analogy is the game of Operation, that you set off a buzzer. You set off a buzzer, and so we know where the trigger is.
Right.
Yeah.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. This first one, I feel like keeps setting that off.
Yeah, I'm trying to get the bone out.
Right. So what's the biggest fear you think people have about this committee?
Seriously.
I mean, because...
I think it depends on who you ask.
Yeah.
I think that there's two general fears. I think one is that this committee has the power to alter measures in a substantive way that changes what they do if we don't like it, right?
Yeah,
and that seems to be an unfounded one, but it still seems to persist.
Right.
I think that the second one is that this committee was intended to have a narrow charge and that we keep sort of reaching outside of that, and I think that was what
we got. That first bullet is not a part, it's not narrow.
Well, so again, it depends on how you interpret
which
what internal applies.
Right.
Because if internal applies to all three and we only focus on what the council does and how the council operates, then it would be outside of our charge to try to say we're going to go through the town's committees and figure out if we can call something, right? Or ask them to review their charges. We don't have the authority to do that. If you see governance as an organization as standing alone outside of internal, then we do. But that was part of the debate, especially with one counselor who just kept saying, you don't have the authority to do this. Why do you think you can do this?
So if we try to squelch these things at committee, then a random group of counselors will propose it anyway, which is a much less tidy way of, handling.
I want to get rid of ad hoc committees as much as possible.
Yes.
I'm with Steve on that. That's harder for the public.
It's harder for everyone.
To follow versus standing committees that have regular meeting times.
Exactly.
And it also adds more burdensome work to our own work in some sense. The fear, I'm already struggling.
Yeah.
There was a fear in even adopting our charge to begin with,
right.
Before anyone even knew who would be serving on it.
Right.
This was one of the charges that had the longest discussion.
And I think was the only non-unanimous vote to create a council.
To create a committee. And I think part of it was, would we be the CRC committee for everything, and that's it. But now we've created a CRC committee that has all of that power, and no one seems to be concerned about that.
I know. See,
which is interesting to me.
Exactly.
Because of that, I don't know. I'm still trying to struggle with what fear around us doing similar stuff for stuff that doesn't relate to the item CRC has been assigned, where that comes from, and I don't know.
Yeah.
I think the fear of any committee is the fear of a concentration of power of among, to five people out of 13 that will essentially make decisions of which the other eight counselors won't have full information how that decision was made. That's legitimate. I mean, that's true of any committee, that all the work that we do to sort of narrow or help the council make a good decision can also be seen as a restricting information or putting a lens on that's
mm-hmm.
– so So that would be true of every committee, not just this committee. I do agree that the existence of now a CRC in a way mitigates the focus on this particular committee. I don't know, we'll see.
Yeah.
We need some stuff to do.
Agree.
We need some action. Yeah.
Yeah. Because I hope you're right. Let me
say
that.
I was gonna, yeah.
Yeah. I guess I really do want to figure out, maybe we have to figure it out with the full council, what that first bullet is about. And have that debate with everybody. I don't know.
I think it would be, so, yes. I don't think you're wrong. I think that given some of the actions we've already taken, we have started. So we've been doing this thing, which I think is really good, in that we've been sort of testing the waters on some things. And so we knew we were going to get some pushback on that recommendation, right?
Mm-hmm. From finance? About finance committee?
No, about
the committees.
That's my second example. About the getting committees to review the charges,
yes.
Right? We knew we were going to get pushback. It passed the council, right?
Right.
So to me, that sort of tacit approval of us doing that, right? Because the majority of the council said, all right, we're going to accept a recommendation from GOL to do this and coordinate this. Then finance, that was the first time where we've really taken some moves. I mean, we eliminated and you know, we did get pushback from one counselor who opened with, I found one substantive change, which I think the subtext to that was, I found something that you weren't supposed to do, right?
Was
that?
Yeah.
Hmm? I don't remember that comment.
That was from the vice chair. About with regard to us removing the text that said about the first term, right?
Yeah.
And yet our revision was passed, right? You explained why, and we sort of said, and I think her concern was primarily that we were getting rid of it completely,
yeah,
right? But when that passed, I kind of smiled to myself because I thought, okay, we actually did something that a lot of people were worried that we would do, and it passed, right? And so I think we're sort of slowly just building these things as we do them. The question is, at what point do we then say, we're going to build this into our charge, and you should be comfortable with that because you've already let us do the, we've done them, and they've gotten majority votes in the council already, right? And so I think it's a debate to have to the council, but I think we come to the council and say, what do you think that bullet means, as opposed to, here's how we've been interpreting that, and we want to clarify that. And you have already approved this kind of
mm-hmm.
stuff. You know, it'd be nice for us to have a position and an explanation
yeah.
as opposed, I wouldn't want to go to the council and say, you know, we've been thinking, what did you mean by this,
yeah.
right?
Right,
yeah.
That makes total sense.
I think I still struggle with everything George has said about do we remain neutral on policy issues? But I think I lean towards adding a third bullet point. We might have to, I think we should reword some of these bullet points for clarity.
I think so, yes.
Number one clearly is not clear. It would not have passed our initial
maybe
right.
review
right.
for clarity,
position
consistency, and actionability.
Position heal thyself.
We really gotta fix our charge.
Right, and I would like to fix our charge.
Yeah.
But I think a third bullet point that makes clear that bullet point number two doesn't include policy reviews, but bullet point number three for maybe bylaws, we should look at the CRC charge. I think mirroring our charge potentially after CRC's wording on some of these might help,
mm-hmm.
but something on CRC that is whatever that charge says about measures or whatever for that relate to public ways, blah, 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 blah. Maybe we have a bullet point that says all measures, or however they worded in CRC, that do not fall under CRC sections, under the CRC charge, comes to us for those reviews. Like
mm-hmm.
somehow mirror
mm-hmm.
that.
That's a good idea.
It would be a separate review. Clearly separating those two issues instead of compounding it into bullet point number two.
Mm-hmm.
We can clear up, point number two actually might actually be somewhat clear once we get measures in there, maybe exempt proclamations or whatever we want to exempt from it. But that, and then when we do those reviews, they get reported separately.
Mm-hmm.
Here's the review with an impact statement or whatever on the policy proposal of this bylaw, and here is separate from that clear, consistent, and actionable declaration or not. It would solve the issue of not needing another standing committee and would potentially solve the ad hoc committee creation issue. It presents the problems George has regularly said are problematic, but I don't know how to address that without creating another committee or dealing with ad hocs. And as we get these other things referred to us already, we're already sort of being that catch-all committee as it is. So to affirmatively state it in a charge is better than not.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just going to put that out there as I think what I favor after all of this discussion.
So I agree with you that I don't want any more ad hoc committees. I agree with you that they have to go somewhere. But I still do share the concern that George has about muddying the waters. But I guess my question
about what?
About muddying the waters of what this committee
yeah.
is and does, because then the question becomes if the matter is referred to us, is it, would it have to be specified that it's referred to us for bullet two versus bullet three? I feel like referrals would then have to become more specific, which I guess isn't really a problem, but because everything still comes to us, right?
Right.
So if something was on zoning, it would have to be made clear that it was being referred to us only for bullet number two, not for bullet number three. Whereas right now you could just say, we're going to send this to GOL because it goes to GOL before it comes to the council, right? So there's a little bit of confusion I have there.
And a zoning change would go to
right. But it would still come
one
out.
Of the, yes,
right.
At the end, yes.
But I think the order
for
would
different
be
reasons.
Yes.
I think well. So what? There's one world, which is only land use issues go to CRC, and the other, and they only go to CRC, and then every other measure goes to GOL. So that's one way to look at this. And that was
so because it would be a zoning bylaw, we wouldn't.
Yeah.
Do
so
that.
Anything to do with land, primarily zoning bylaw, but there are other land use bylaws also. So that would be one way to divide the labor. Those all go to CRC, never to GOL. And then all other bylaws or measures go to GOL and never to CRC.
I think everything goes to GOL, though. Right? Because we're that consistent.
But it doesn't have
clarity.
To.
Yeah, but I think it should.
Well, then we have to
well this year.
Too.
Yeah,
the proposed rules
I mean,
will have
it could change.
Bylaw change.
Yeah. I mean,
coming
I feel
to see
strongly
coming to GOL at the
both
end.
Both GOL and for different reasons, and CRC need to look at zoning bylaw changes right now or land use changes. I don't think that, I think that in some ways, and I don't mean this in any way negatively about that, but I feel like there is a way in which the planning board needs to go through CRC, and if they're making changes to bylaws, whether they're zoning or other, they need to come here.
Yeah, so the planning board only has authority to make recommendations regarding the zoning bylaw. That's the only part
right.
that they can we can refer questions about rental bylaw or something like that if it's not in the zoning bylaw. But that's their only purview is the zoning bylaw.
Right.
So zoning is highly nuanced and highly, you know, it's a whole world of, and it's a very important world town. Yeah, yeah. So then a town like, you know, a place like Amherst, it's really the zoning, in other words, if you look at the TMAC proposal, that's really where the concern is, the zoning bylaw. So,
I don't think that's the only concern. But
that's where the primary concern is, I'm sorry.
Yes.
the examples that they use were all zoning bylaw. So we on the CRC will take a equally, you know, we'll take a equally nuanced look at it, and we'll look at all these things, consistency, clarity. I don't know if the, because it's...
I don't know if that's our job. I think our job is impact. And that's...
Okay. That's interesting.
Yeah, I'm seeing it as, because clarity, actionability, and consistency feels like it belongs here. It's about how a bylaw is written and whether it conflicts with a mass general law. But when we're talking, there's another level to any change in zoning or land use or that has to do with what impact will it have. And that impact can be,
so,
and we don't know, hopefully, we don't necessarily know the answers until we begin to look at it from more than one angle. Because it's easy to say, it's great because, you know, we're going to increase the tax base, so now let's get a 10, we're not doing this, a 10-story building with an ostrich farm on the roof, and blah, blah, blah.
What kind?
Ostrich.
Ostrich or emu?
Or
emu. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I like ostrich better. But I guess what I'm saying is that we really do need to look at impact. I wish we could talk about
without using that word.
No.
Are we talking about CRC
now? No, we're talking
now?
About finding
another committee.
Possible places for the DPW.
Right.
Okay.
Yes.
And
fire station.
And,
yeah.
Yeah.
And school.
And our and all of that.
No,
and
fine.
So, what are the impacts of putting the DPW next to the Jones Library? What's the that's
or the new school, the impact at Fort River versus putting that school at Wildwood or some other site.
And not just, but that impacts traffic, it impacts usage, it impacts the silence of the library, although I haven't heard that lately. I'm maybe not getting the best, but do you have a sense of what I'm trying to say?
Yeah. So that would be definitely something that CRC would probably weigh in. Because I guess I'm thinking of more like the, but that's not a bylaw, so that would never come here. Because in other words, looking at, the DPW on the CVS lot would not be a bylaw change. But it might require a zoning change. So
that's a zoning bylaw, and we would then have to look at it in this committee to see whether it was actionable.
But okay, so here's where we need actual real cases.
Yeah.
So let's take form-based zoning. Now let's take a proposal to lower the height of buildings downtown to one story. So the CRC would look at that very carefully. We have to look at the clarity, consistency, and actionability, because if it's none of those, in other words, first of all, the planning board is already doing that, but we would take another look at that.
Right.
See, I see it as different forms of sandpaper. So then coming to the DOL to me seems either redundant or sort of clogging up what the DOL can be doing best.
How many bylaws do you want to change?
I don't. Apparently there's a whole backlog of them waiting for us. I haven't actually been following. But I think that by the time the CRC / working with the planning board is done with it, it would meet all the standards that we're normally looking for. So I think then sending it here, then this group, which right now happens to have two people from the other committee, would be basically taking the same look. I don't know. We need examples.
Yeah.
So any kind of a zoning bylaw change will be referred to the CRC at least, and will be referred to the finance committee, because the financial impact of land use changes is really important.
And then it will ultimately whether it's legal to do. Which CRC isn't necessarily doing a legal review.
The planning board definitely does.
The planning board does.
They would pitch that to the, and the planning board is required to do all the public hearings. So those all have to be done by the planning board.
Right.
That doesn't mean that we can't also do them. And there's town attorney review, et cetera.
So CRC, I pulled up its charge. Planning, zoning, land use, public way, public resources, housing, homelessness, relationship between the town and institutions of higher education, master plan, and measures to support the local economy.
And we forgot to add ranked choice voter.
So it's missing anything related to, say, elections.
No, we're going to get that here.
Anything related to elections, budgeting of some sorts, most of which would go to finance. But there could be measures that aren't necessarily, finance looks at financial impacts, but not necessarily measures. So I'm wondering about participatory budgeting. If they come back with a bylaw, does the bylaw review go to finance? Probably.
Yeah.
So the elections portion, in public safety in a way, anything enforcement related to public safety, you could argue, which might be noise, noise and rental registration and potentially, although that
probably
rental registration
housing.
Relates to housing and homelessness, but there's definitely some stuff that does not fall within CRC's charge. And the question is, the question is, this is going to be a conversation, whatever we propose, that town council is going to have a field day with it. So what do we want our proposal to be? And I think the decision comes down to put it into our charge or ask that another council committee be created.
Oh, no.
With a potential of, if we ask that to be created, do we take our committee charge down to 3 members?
Yes. I appreciate that anyway. Not that I don't love serving.
I think
we get through this first hump, we don't need to be 5-person committee.
Unless some of what's on the CRC, I think the CRC charge is too big.
Yeah.
And I think it's sort of crazy big. But we're also getting a snapshot on what municipal governments actually do, right? So much, because we're basically a subdivision of the state, right? So much of what we can do is already defined by the state. So what's allocated for towns to do, well, schools is more or less handled by the school committee. Land use. So almost everything that the municipal governments do that the school committees don't do is on that list that you just did.
So I would be, given now that we have CRC, and given that nearly everything I can think of would be referred to CRC, who I agree has maybe an charge that's too expansive, but you wrote it, so.
I fought it a little bit.
You were out that day.
I would be probably okay with a bullet that said something along the lines of review and make recommendations to the town council on matters referred to GOL that don't fit with another committee that last language is not.
Other duties as assigned.
Yeah, I mean, to some extent, it could just be review and make recommendations
other related
to town
duties
council on other matters referred to GOL. And so with the idea being that if we as a council take some bylaw and we're like, you know what, we're not sure we can jam this into CRC, it just doesn't seem to fit, but it also shouldn't go to finance, nothing should ever go to OCA, then, maybe we say, okay, we're going to utilize that third bullet. But I think maybe keeping it vague, other matters, that allows them to give stuff to us if it has no other home, but doesn't require them to send anything to us.
You're shaking your head.
I think it's a bad idea, but that's all right.
Well, say it.
I've said it already. going to meet a lot of resistance, I think, from some other councilors. We're trying to carve out a policy role for this committee, and many people, including myself, originally understood this committee not to be a policy-creating body. It has a more technical-focused task. And now what I'm hearing from all of you, or most of you, is that you want to carve out, by a third bullet point, some kind of potential policy-generating or forming function for this committee. And maybe I'm mishearing, so you can correct me on that. But if what I'm hearing is correct, I'm very uncomfortable with that. And secondly, I think there are going to be a lot of people on the council that are going to, you know, be very uncomfortable with it. So if we do go this route, I think it's important that we be very clear on what it is this third bullet point will be, and hopefully we can come to some consensus. At the moment, I couldn't join in, but I don't know what this third bullet point looks like yet. But and in the end, I could be outvoted, which is fine, but I'm very uncomfortable with this at the moment. But maybe we should try and write up a third bullet point so we at least have something concrete to look at.
Would you favor the creation of a separate standing committee to cover the non-CRC stuff?
I think it's going to just come out in the wash, as it has already. I mean, you know, and so far it hasn't been a problem. It gets to be a problem. I guess maybe we'll have to deal with it. But, you know, as in the case with the finance issue in the last town council meeting, with your able assistance, it was cleared up, and that was the end of the story. So the supposed crisis of, you know, us, you know, making policy decisions was dealt with quite simply. But if we do end up making policy decisions, then, so I prefer that, it's just going to have to come out in the wash, in my sense. We're trying to figure out what's going to happen in the future. We have no idea.
Maybe we need to wait just, and see if there is something that comes that nobody...
Write me a third bullet point that I can at least look at and think about. Right now, you know, Evan's trying, I know, but basically other matters referred to GOL, and everyone in the council is going to go, what?
I think every single committee ought to have the other matters.
Probably, yeah.
Because I don't think reducing the size.
Well, let's set that aside.
Yeah,
it's
necessarily the way to go.
We had
because
enough
I think
on
that
here.
This
let's
can
just
be.
Focus on whether we
I
want
think
to
that
a third bullet point.
Stuff that's actually on the CRC should be. I mean, we need to get started.
Yeah.
But I think that things that are going to be referred to the CRC should maybe more appropriately be referred to the
us.
GOL, and I think
really?
That the GOL should have a, this is my opinion,
right.
I think the GOL should have a parallel mission as the CRC, only they handle different parts, different issues. That's my opinion. I don't think they should handle the same issues. I don't think that, I don't like the planning and zoning bylaws get referred to both. I think it's too much. I think it's going to be confusing, and I think that it will be it'll mean that really good possible changes to the zoning bylaw, and there are bad changes, there are good changes, could go into an endless loop of referrals.
Evan, do you want to take a stab at recrafting our charge?
I can.
We have a Word document template
like
I can forward you. I have not been able to find the Word template for our current charge. We might have it, though. While we're recrafting it, we should craft it into the template since it doesn't follow it at all.
Yeah, we should probably at least have our own charge.
Yes. So, do you want to take a stab at modifying the first bullet point? These will all become numbers as or letters as we do this. But the first and the third. Well,
we don't
sort
have
of agreed on the second. Do you want to try that? Since I'm trying to assign other people work.
Yeah. No, I can. And you can tell me. You go.
And then we'll have something
quiet.
To look at and actually concretely discuss instead of theoretical.
Pardon me?
He's making some good arguments.
I know.
Where we might come in
I was saying,
charge and our charge and this charge. We're just going to do it all. Yeah. And everyone will hate us. So Evan is going to take a stab at a GOL charger.
And you're asking him, I take it, if I, to craft a third bullet point or a third number or a third letter, whatever, to reflect to some degree the discussion we've been having. And he's going to make some changes to the first bullet point as well. And
yes.
Can we talk about it? I mean, maybe we should just shut up and we'll look at it when it's in front of us.
The first one, I think, is just to become more clear on what...
how we've been interpreting it.
Yes.
Right.
Oh.
But I think George has disagreed
who's
with our interpretation.
Who's we, Kemosabe?
I think
we
based on the actions that we have taken.
Up to point. No, I understand. So you feel that needs to be, and you will obviously revise it, and then we'll have something to look at. And I can, if I have a problem with it, then I can say what I think. But good, okay.
We'll get a.
It's an action. That's an action.
Section.
I can write down an action. Okay.
Yeah.
Evan is going to do something.
Evan is assigned something. We'll get a purpose. And we'll get a
and
it's all sorts of things.
Sometime next year.
That is we'll get report section. We'll get.
Okay, so that's the GOL committee charge discussion. And Evan is going to be asked to revise the GOL charge for further discussion at next meeting.
Yeah.
Okay. These minutes are going to reflect a discussion then followed. With the motion, with the action that.
Brings us to public comment.
No public present.
See none. We are on to adoption of March 27th and April 10th minutes. There is a revision to the April 10th, a revised version that was emailed out to the April 10th minutes. Are there any other recommended revisions to either March 27 or April 10?
I'll move to approve both.
So the motion is to approve the March 27th and April 10th revised minutes as presented. Is there a second?
I would second.
Any discussion?
Which one?
No. Steve sent out the revision.
The only comment I have on April 10th. Does it say that we heard public comment from those three people?
I'm sorry, I don't have my version in front of me.
It says the committee held a lengthy discussion with the members of the public present. So are we counting that as presented as public comment? There's no.
It says there was no additional.
Right. So that's referring to under five. The committee held a lengthy discussion with the members of the public press.
Yes.
I just wanted to make sure that was.
And he identified who the members of the public press
were
on the top.
I just wanted to make sure that it was recognized that we did have people who talked.
Yes.
All right.
Yeah.
We kind of went off the script because we started talking to them early.
Yeah.
We officially sort of moved the public comment up to that and then just included them in the discussion. Per agreement of the committee to do so. Any more further comment on this motion? All those in favor? That is unanimous. We will be caught up on our minutes. I have one item not anticipated in advance.
Bonus
item. Do we want to modify in any way the public way policy that we brought forth to the council 2 days ago based on the council's discussion? I think the biggest comment was a comment on do we want reports of what banners are going up. We had exempted that from the policy. Do we want to come back to the council with a modified policy?
I don't think so.
Yeah.
I don't need a report on banners. But
so it looks like we're okay with sticking with the policy we originally presented.
Yeah.
That was my one item not anticipated.
Next time we should turn that one on.
I tried it earlier, we're getting feedback.
Before we adjourn,
so.
I should really start putting this, I'm gonna, future agenda items. We've got, in the near future, our charge. We have the council goals document will be on our next agenda per email of the president. So I will add that to it.
And this, this is the worksheet that we're looking at, correct? So there's
the
document. There's a list of goals, which pretty much got ignored, which is fine. And then the worksheet.
Yes.
And that's what we'll be looking at.
And she's requested all the committees
to
put
and
them.
So we should go through it at some point, saying this to myself as much as anyone, and find those, because I've worked on this thing, for, right? But find those parts that say GOL, and you should look at that, and either
right.
go, or go, yeah. Or maybe think
right.
of other places where we should.
And I will send out some documents on that
Thanks.
Sooner because we've gotten an email from the president with specific requests. I think that went to the whole council, but
I
I'm
think
not
so
sure.
Too.
I received, as chair of GOL, an email from Alyssa as chair of rules where she reassigned stuff to GOL instead of rules. So there is a modified one from her that we should all look at since rules will no longer be in existence in about a month.
Yeah, so we shouldn't be assigning anything to the ad hoc.
Right, so.
Yeah.
I heard y'all met for 4 hours yesterday morning.
3 hours and 45 minutes.
The rules committee?
Rules.
Rules.
3 hours and 45
We will
minutes.
Have rules as of the April,
Did they broke
the
you
May
to
6th meeting. There will be a complete set of rules.
By the May 6th meeting?
By the May 6th meeting.
So you touched the last megabyte of YouTube space.
3 hours.
So the council goals discussion
right.
worksheet, our charge. The other things that I had on future agenda items is discussion on the town committee organization and structure, and then updating, I had four charges, one of which is ours, JCPC, BCG, and OCA charge for template conformity. I don't really want to tackle OCA at all
no.
right now. But BCG was specifically referred to us at some point long in the past.
Mm-hmm.
So do I have a volunteer, as I've tried to push it off of my plate, for someone to take a look at the BCG charge and try and put it into the template?
Hmm.
I didn't think I'd get volunteers.
Well, no,
no.
She's
no.
untied.
Do you,
yeah.
does anyone want to? I can do
I
it.
Can do
I,
it. I don't want to do anything,
well,
but I can, I can do it.
Probably good.
I'm already putting our charge into the our template
right.
to
Is
do
that
this
really okay?
So.
That'd be great. If you
okay.
Yeah.
George, we have BCG and JCPC. None of us are on BCG, right? Right. I'm on JCPC, so I'll tackle from that charge.
So you will do JCPC, and Evan is going to do both BCG. And our NGOL.
I just propose that since our list of topics is low, they are not high, don't worry about getting it for the next meeting at BCG.
If I don't, then I'll forget.
Okay.
Right, I'm with you. Right, either do
so
it or right.
Gonna
yeah, it's just going to get lost. I agree.
But I thought we might be able to move some of them up.
Okay, so updating charges.
I will not put discussion of town committee organization and structure on the next meeting agenda. I'm going to hold that.
Yeah.
Continue to hold that.
Okay.
We should, though, at some point talk, maybe in two meetings, about how we want to go about implementing the recommendation the council adopted about having other
So that's action. We have two further action items related to template conformity and one action item related to Evan. Well, sorry, that's the same action item. Okay. All right.
I think that's it. Anyone have anything else?
Half hour early. Push it back from the gate, half hour early.
Soon it'll be like 20 minutes.
I know.
It'll be like a well, I know, down three. So.
I need a motion to adjourn.
I would move to adjourn.
Second.
All those in favor? We are unanimously adjourned at noon.
12.